So to do this, we're going to use something called Arc Catalog, which is a kind of a good place to manage files. And so let's go ahead and open up Arc Catalog. And I'm going to do that by just typing in slowly Arc Catalog. Anyway. It's going to be this guy. It's the filing cabinet with the globe in the bottom drawer, which is where you tend to keep the globe, I guess. And I'm going to open this guy up, and then there's going to be, hopefully, it kind of looks like Windows, like this guy, except that if you use a Mac, that doesn't really help you a whole lot. So let's do a few things. The first thing I need to do is connect to the place that I want to work, which is the folder I think we just created. So if I right click on this guy, right? So I'm right click on folder connections, then left click on that connect to folder option, and now I'm going to navigate to that place on Splinter that I just set up, lab 1, and say okay. And there's my first raster, which is nice, right? So now what I'd like to do is, okay, so that was, let's just keep track here, like, these are the kind of the things you do when you start a project. And I'm gonna say these include things like connect to folder. Okay, so what else do you do? Next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a file geodatabase, which is just basically a place to kind of to store a bunch of geographic data. And so to do this, creating a file geodatabase, I'm going to go into this lab 1 folder, right click on it, say new, file geodatabase. I'm not going to get sucked into this personal geodatabase. Nothing personal, but we don't... nothing personal. That's our role in this class. It's all about files. So let's go to the file geodatabase. And that should just pop up. File, not a very creative name. So let's call this one. If I right-click on it, it says rename, and I'd like to call this my lab 1 geodatabase. And I even got rid of that .gdb, if you noticed, but it seems like it's okay with that because it knows it. And so I've got this kind of cylinder there, right? It looks like a big water tank. And that's going to be where this is going to act like a fancy folder where we're going to wind up putting all of the data that we create, which we're about to do. But we have to do a couple things first. So the next thing I'm going to do is go into geoprocessing and go to my geoprocessing options. And in my experience, I find it best to go ahead and disenable this background processing. So uncheck that enable button and say OK. And that makes everything run a little bit smoother. So I'm going to say disenable background processing. Fair enough. Something I encourage you to do pretty much every time you start up a project. Just make sure if you move computers, you may have to do that more than once. Next thing I'd like to do is go under geoprocessing and go to my environments. And I want to define my current workspace. So at the very top here, I'm going to go under my folder connections, go to lab 1, and click the, actually, you know what, I think I'm just going to click this and say I'm going to use lab 1 as my working area. And actually, you know what, I'm going to go in and I'm going to say that the GDB is my workspace. I think that's going to save clicking down the line, and I'm all about kind of saving clicking, so that should add that there. And then the Scratch workplace isn't that imperative, but I'm going to also kind of define it. And so what this is saying is that I'm going to be working, my default place to work is in this lab one file database. And the default place to kick out a raster while you're kind of working for me that may be temporary is going to be this place as well. And that's just kind of a good opening habit to get into, is to define your workspace there. It, again, sometimes Arc is quirky, but that should save us kind of some clicks later on. Okay, so that was my last bit here, is I kind of set my kind of environments. And in this case, what I did was defined the current workspace. Cool. And let's just clean this up. So this was actually setting, I think they were called geoprocessing options or something along those lines, right? And then this was called setting the environments. Okay, thanks. Sorry for the drowsiness. That's a dry bit, setting up a workspace, but that's good stuff that I wanted you to know.